Hi everyone, welcome to today's lesson. It's the second in this series. We're looking at portrait sketching in graphite. So last week we kind of established the initial blocking of the face. This week we're going to be carrying on, mostly working in the darker tones. So these shadows have been blocked in, we're going to start to develop and not worry too much about any of the half tones, though we might just start to work, kind of blend into them a bit. In some of my videos, there's a bit more distinction between stages, but with this one, we're just kind of naturally allow things to kind of work together. So at times it's more efficient if you work groups of tones together, so you don't have to keep your shadows and lights totally distinct. But we'll largely be focusing on darker tones in this video. Once again, my tools are just going to be this set of four different mechanical pencils. So I've got one quite hard, kind of H, I think it's a 2mm lead, and then a softer, like a B 2mm lead, and then kind of similar with my 0.5mm. They're going to be, I think one of them is a B, one is an HB, something like that. Kind of like a range of different hardnesses depending on what kind of effect I want to get. So generally if you want to lay down kind of heavier tones or a kind of softer, smudgier pencil stroke, you can use your softer pencils. And if you want to kind of slowly build up tone, but it's going to be a bit harder, you can use your harder leads. But yeah, let's get started. So while we're doing this, we can correct some shapes as well. So it wasn't entirely perfect last week. So as I start to kind of rework some of these darker tones, I'm going to also alter the shapes to a certain extent. Sometimes as you add to the darker tones, it also develops the shape as well. So first thing I'm going to look for are my darkest portions of the shadows, which I'm getting quite dark tones. Down that side of the hair. Can also use it as an opportunity to search out the hairline as well. You can see the image kind of slowly starting to take shape. Working pretty much the same way across the whole surface. So I'm just looking for the largest shapes that I want to block in. Not being too precious with it. It's sort of moderately scratchy. You can go for a different sorts of finishes. So from something that's scratchy, we're going to probably end up working it to be quite smooth. But you could leave it like this if you liked. That's kind of down to a matter of taste really, more than anything. But the primary thing is we're just focusing on these darker tones. But I have slipped a little bit into times I've worked more in the half tones, perhaps, or what you'd call the half tones. You also don't have to necessarily nail the value immediately as you work. So you might find you have to search around a little bit to get the right value. So we're getting there with this. We worked our way across quite a lot. Quite a lot of the shadows, kind of nearing the end of them. Just work down into the neck. And I tend to get even looser as I work into portions of the figure. That move away from the eyes and the mouth and the kind of central aspect, I suppose, of any figure. So that tends to be what the eye wants to focus on, so it's good to kind of lead them towards that by creating a focal point. Likewise for the clothing, I don't want to go too detailed with it. We can maybe go a bit more detailed later, make a decision about that. For the time being, just want to keep it nice and simple. So working our way around, kind of almost there with the lips. Lips have quite a lot of halftones, so just kind of roughly block them in, but not develop them too much. Not too much of the chin either. We'll be going through and reinforcing the darks and smoothing them out later when we get into our kind of refinement stage. But at the moment, we're just kind of, I guess, finishing our initial sort of initial statement for what's going on with the figure and in the image. And this will give us a base to work from where we can start to refine stuff, polish certain bits off. Last thing left to do is just this. This right hand eye. I've got it mostly blocked in, so it shouldn't take too long. So it's not too bad, actually, that. It's roughly blocked in. And gives us, again, another platform, a developed platform to carry on working next week. It's not at all refined, but that's what the later stages are for. Just to show you how quickly you can kind of working on that sort of construct below, how much you can get done. And once you get this this shadow blocked in, it starts to come together and makes it a lot easier. Makes it a lot easier to develop the rest of the image. I might mess around with it too much because this is the sort of thing I'm going to be doing next lesson. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So you're just working over the shadows, just creating a variety of tones in your darker tones. So you're not working in the lights too much. We want to keep them quite bright. Next time we're going to be roughing in our half tones, and then from there we can start to polish things off as much as we like. So once we put the half tones in, the drawings could essentially be complete. You can maybe pick out some certain areas to refine. We'll probably do that, so we'll pick out sort of the eyes and the mouth, nose, really refine the rendering on those parts and see how far that pushes the drawing, and then subsequent lessons I'll push it a little bit further and go to a kind of completion in the rest of the image as well. But yeah, that's pretty much it for today. As always, subscribe so you can watch future videos from myself and other tutors. If you follow the link through to OCAD, you can sign up and get one-on-one tuition with myself and a bunch of other specialist tutors to help you develop your work. If you do sign up, I look forward to seeing what you do, and I'll see you guys soon.